So I thought I would make something a little bit different today for you guys. Getting into the spring season, just about time to mow. And I wanted to show you guys, Old Faithful here, the old John Deere LT-133, I believe it is, mower that we have here. This thing is by far the worst condition, ugliest looking, terrible lawnmower that we have here on our property. And I'll tell you what, we've been mowing with it for a couple years now, and it mows really well. You wouldn't believe that this thing is still going strong after so much crap I'm about to show you is wrong with this lawnmower. So besides the usual old age on lawnmowers where the tires go flat, you know, every month, we'll take a quick walkthrough on this thing. First thing you're gonna notice is there's no cover. That's one of those reverse, the cover opens this way on those plastic hinges. Those hinges decided to break long ago, fell apart. We tried to duct tape the hood on. As you drive, the hood shifted, actually fell over, ran part of it over with the wheel. It shattered the hood into more plastic pieces, and I threw it in the trash because that was just something annoying me. You will notice as we go through this, if something annoys me on this mower, I throw it in the trash because I just want this to work. I don't care about looks. So continuing on, we have our handy dandy muffler box right here in the front. This thing is actually cracked off twice now because there is a broken motor mount on this engine that is snapped off, sheared off in the actual block. So there's part of that engine just vibrates against the frame, which the vibrations travel down this muffler box and eventually crack it loose every single time. I've got one bolt left holding it on over there. That one there is welded, which is already broken from last fall probably. It's starting to wear out the welds there. We got a little bit of spider cracking. I'll probably have to re-weld it a couple more mow from now, more trips through the yard. But it'll hold on there at least for a few more rounds. Working our way around this thing. You will notice this does look a little bit weathered on the top here. And that is because this thing has actually caught on fire. Not once, but twice since I've had it in mode with it. Just build up leaves, grease, oil, whatever else is on this engine, ignited it one day and it started burning. Conveniently, that's when the cover was already off of it, thankfully. So while it was burning, I just drove it around to the back, got the garden hose, sprayed it, put it out, and kept on mowing. So it's still going strong. Unbelievably, it has melted through part of this top guard. You see some of the fins here on this blade have melted off, but hey, you know what? That's just looks. It still functions just fine. Also, you'll notice we have this thing hooked up to jumper cables. That's because this battery took a crap a couple years ago. And to be honest, something that's really an absolute waste on lawnmowers is a lawnmower battery. Because once you start a lawnmower, you really don't need the battery to keep mowing. It's just there to engage your starter. After that, it kind of just self-feeds and keeps on going with power until you turn it off. So why waste the money to replace a battery every so many years on your mower when all you have to do is use a normal car battery, hook it to a jump cable, put jumpers on it, start your lawnmower, unplug it, and go mow. That you do this every time you mow and you never need another battery. So, of course, with me being a demolition derby guy, we have derby batteries laying all over the place. Comes in good handiness for this. Working our way around, also, all of these safety features pretty much are non-existent on this lawnmower anymore. So this thing is basically a death trap on wheels. Everything's quit working in regards to the actual key safety switch. Now it does nothing. It turns, it does not crank, does not turn this thing on or off. There used to be a safety feature with the blade when you turned it off. It's underneath this dash here. That right there is actually unplugged because it shorted out. With it plugged in, the lawnmower does not function. There is a switch somewhere under this seat where if you were leaning or getting up off the seat that it would turn the mower off. You see that is also unplugged because it has also shorted out and does no longer work. Couple other switches. I believe there is a switch for reverse. Yes, right here. This button that you push to go in reverse and keep the blade on without it accidentally turning off the blade when you go into reverse. Yeah, that definitely doesn't work anymore either. Totally gone. So ignore that. All this stuff is just pretty much gone the way of the wind many years prior on the life of this thing. And this is a well-worn engine. It's very troublesome when it first starts, but once it fires up, this thing runs top-notch, surprisingly. Only have to add oil once a year. Still is not burning a whole bunch of it. It's not leaking anything out of it, so very impressed by that. No idea the mileage or the hours that are on this, because this is before they put them on these mowers. This is like a 2001, 2003 model John Deere. If I can guess correctly, I think is when this came out. So being 2021 right now, we're pushing almost 20 years on this lawnmower. Pretty impressive, I must say. Now here's something else that's really gonna throw you guys for a good surprise. You see our well-worn coil with the pickup magnet right here. This is definitely heavily burnt from the fires. But here is your plug wire that goes down to the spark plug. It's also burned, frayed, everything in between there. But if you just reach up here and give this a nice little tug, ta-da, there is your actual wire that goes through the boot to your spark plug. Yes, it's completely burnt and frayed, and I don't know really what's going on. So what we do is we just ignore that. That's the secret here to making this mower last so long, is you just ignore all the problems and it just keeps running. So we just shove that little wire right back in that boot as if nothing happened. And honestly, it's as good as it's gonna get right there. So we have maintained it though as far as reliability. We do the oil changes, we keep our fluids topped off, we have a sharpened blade. Speaking of the blade, you will notice we do not have a wheel at all on the front of this deck right here. That guy decided to leave us last year. Made it a long time, you know, almost 20 years for the wheel. So congrats to him for surviving so long. We were mowing and it just decided to actually drive itself away from the mower. Saw the wheel just take a ride and go rolling off on its own. Now, if we go to the other side of the deck, this is where it gets better. This side here also does not have the wheel. You see, that one actually decided to fall off and proceed to get sucked into the mower and shred itself. So that wheel definitely never coming back to us. You will see here we have this handy dandy plate that has been welded on here. This was actually before my ownership. So this thing has seen some serious redneck creativity. Somebody had just worn a hole through that, maybe from rocks, mulch, whatever, scraping up in there. Maybe the blade went off track. I don't know. Regardless, they did this bubblegum repair job with the welder, and believe it or not, it has not broke with whatever they've done. So, cool. We'll see how long that keeps lasting. Not like we need it anymore since the wheel no longer exists. And coming up here, we do have our shield, which is still in one piece, surprisingly. That'll probably be the next thing to leave this. Unfortunately, the rod that holds it on has worn out. There's no longer a set pin or nut or anything that holds it on there. So we have this duct tape. We just wrapped a few strands of duct tape around it, and all that does is make that rod diameter a little bit bigger, so this rod itself cannot slide out from the vibrations while you mow. Works pretty darn good as long as you don't mow in a rainstorm and get the duct tape wet. Other than that, it's doing just fine. So now we're gonna go ahead and try to fire this thing up first for this year. It's gonna be a bit of a fight, I imagine, based on its past performances. It's been since fall, so at least a good 6 months. We have 6 month old gas sitting in it then, because I do fill all my lawnmowers up completely full to the top right at the end of the season, so it has gas, a little bit better chance of surviving than a little bit empty on the bottom of that. So we'll get some 6 month old gas sucked into it to see if we can get it to fire off. And yes, we have some starting spray here. Now you might be thinking, oh, he's gonna use starting spray because this mower is sitting. No, we actually are gonna use starting spray because this mower is crap and we have to use a little bit of spray every single time we start it just because it needs that help. The compression is terrible in this engine. Last, I did forget to mention, you know, I said the key doesn't work. That also means there is no way to turn this thing off. When you are mowing, there's no way to kill the power supply. The only way we can actually turn this thing off is we have this handy dandy lever for your choke system, which still works, thankfully. So what we do is once we start this mower and choke, we get it fired up, set her to your turtle or your rabbit, whatever you want to run that thing at. And at the end of the day, when you're done mowing, you just whip it up really fast straight into 100% choke, where it will suffocate the engine. It'll pop, maybe backfire, and then it stalls out. That's how we turn this thing off. But ladies and gentlemen, this here, why am I still using it? Because this was a 100% free lawnmower that we got just for picking up from a friend of ours several years ago. And before, you know, everyone starts going crazy below the comments of this video saying, my goodness, just take the money and buy another mower. I actually have two other John Deere mowers that are in much, much better condition than this one. Just to prove it here, show you a quick flash. I have the exact twin to that one sitting here in the garage. We have another John Deere LT133 right here. Much better off. Nothing broken on it besides that crappy plastic hood that I threw away happily long ago. Other than that, this one has not caught on fire or many other issues in between. But my goal was to use the free one as a parts lawnmower whenever this one needed it. But surprisingly, that free one cut so even and so well with that fresh blade on it that we're going to keep using it until something breaks on that mower to become a parts lawnmower. So my guess is it's going to keep going until the engine blows on that other mower, because these things are just crazy reliable with the powertrains. Also, I do have a John Deere LA14 in here, much newer model, wider cut for this thing here. This is our really nice quality mower that we have sitting here. So I do have other alternatives should our crazy little Frankenstein creation fail us one day. But that gives you a nice little rundown. We're gonna go ahead and try to start this thing. Let's see if we can get it going, fired up for the fresh cutting season of 2021 lawnmower. Alright, we got our handy dandy screwdriver here. Forgot to mention, in order to start it, you do have to reach way down in there and jump the terminals on the solenoid, because everything else is pretty much quit working with the wiring system. So we're gonna reach that solenoid, we're gonna apply a little bit of choke to it with the brake press down, see if we can get it to fire. Things are broken, but it still cuts grass, and that's all that matters to me.